Hi, this is Tim Smith, and this is another video in the 10-Minute Expert Series. Today I'm going to talk with you about how to resolve conflicts in jar files when you're doing Java development work inside of Informatica. Now, whether you're developing Java code inside of a Java transformation on PowerCenter or in data services or data quality, the way that gets executed is inside the environment there's a Java Virtual Machine or JVM, and inside of it is a class loader. Now, when you request a class, the class loader is responsible for finding it, and it looks down the class path. It looks in jar files and class files. These files are organized not just within those within jar files to group them together, but also in package names. In this example, you see a Java transformation that's importing from the package org.example. When a request is made to create an object of this type, the class loader goes out and searches the disk for the file that contains that class. And it will load that class, all the definitions of executable, and allow it to be executed. This works fine until you are using different versions and when you're not able to maintain compatibility. For example, a method might get deprecated. And for example, I might have where the first example here, we have a find data that's being passed along, a number. Now I need to pass a string because I'm using a new version of the method and it only expects a string. Well, the class loader can go out and find that as long as you've got the jar file. And again, this works fine as expected. But what happens if you need to use the old and the new version of the jar file? So in that case, your first execution might work, may or may not, depends on how the class loader, which class it finds first. But if we find the class name, and that's loaded, and then we try to use the other version, the class loader will get a conflict with the two different versions and will not allow a duplicate class name to be loaded, and the request will fail because it can't find something to fulfill the method signature. So the core problem is that Java does not like the same class name being loaded twice. So there are a couple of ways you can deal with this. The first is if you have access to the source code, you can change the source code for your libraries. So in this example, we'll change org example to org example v2. So the package name gets changed and there won't be a conflict anymore. There was another little utility that I found called Jar Jar Links, and this is very useful when you're using libraries like Apache Commons or Log4j or other libraries such as that. If you're using those libraries and Informatica uses those libraries, then it's very possible to hit a conflict if one is using a newer package than the other, newer version of the library. So what Jar Jar Links does is it allows you to change the package name for a package. And for example, I can then have a jar file that contains org.example and my first Java transformation can work. Then my second Java transformation will import org.example underscore v2. So I've renamed it to v2, and inside of a jar file in my appropriate folder, I'll have org.example v2. So even though the original class file referred to org.example, this is able to go into the jar file and just rename the different class or packages. So let me give you a quick example, a quick demonstration. I've created an example to show how this works. I have a class called shared class that's in the package org.bogus. It has two different methods. The first is version, and it returns a string that is the version, so v1. The second is say something, and say something accepts two parameters, two strings, and all it does is concatenate those together. I have another Java file called shared class, and this is my second version. So this is my newer version. And when I ask for a version, I should get V2. But now, instead of hardwired two strings, I now take an array of strings. And these get concatenated together and return. And it also adds a space in between the different parts. So two classes with the same name. And now above that, I have a test harness. And the test harness is just test 1 and test 2. Both assume different versions of shared class. Test 1 has run test, and you specify, or that is, it calls the shared class, concatenates the version with a concatenate string first and second. So it calls say something with first and second. The second does the same thing, but it expects a different method signature. It is passing the string array. Now I can compile these and run test 1 with this shared class, and it's going to execute fine. I can run test 2 with this shared class, and it's going to execute fine. And if that's all I need to do inside of Informatica was call one of these, then I would be fine, as long as nothing else was referring to a different version. But I want to force a failure, so this is the way I did that. I have two Java transformations inside of a mapping in a logical object, and these are calling the two different tests. You'll see here I'm calling test 1, and here I'm calling test 2. And it takes those values, whatever those return, and output it. So I can preview. And here I'm getting version V1 with a result first and second, so those got concatenated together. Now let's call this one, and you'll see I've already got the error message there. It says no such method error. So it loaded the class. It went ahead and loaded this class, and now that it's loaded, it can't see the other class. The location of the jar files is found in the services shared jars third party. And that's where you can add your own jar files. And I have compiled those four different files into four different jars. And those are the V1, V2, test harness V1, test harness V2. So we have a conflict with the V1 and V2 that we need to resolve. The way I'll resolve that is by combining the test harness V2 with my V2 jar, and then changing the contents of that so that the package is different for the V2 jar. You can see what is inside of a jar, what the packages are, by using jar. And see, I've got org bogus shared class there, and inside my test harness V2, I have org test harness test 2. So I'm going to combine these two together into one jar file, and then I'm going to change org bogus to another path or another package. So let's go ahead and get rid of the V2 jar and the test harness V2. And I'll copy the v2x.jar. So the v2x, I have renamed org bogus to be orgx org bogus. So I've added another layer on top of it. The test2 class was inside the same folder. And when I ran the utility on this jar file, it changed the test2 class to look at this path instead of the previous path or package. So everything's combined together. Now I've got one jar file that has everything that I need. Now I should be able, unless I've done something very wrong, should now be able to preview this. And you'll see that my version 1 is working and my version 2 is working. Note that the first and second has a space in between it, and V2 got returned. Now, how did it work? How does this magic work? I'm going to show you a batch file that I created. And in this, what I'm doing is I compile the various files. The shared class is compiled. The test harness version 1 and version 2 are compiled. And they are then jarred. So I jar to V1, V2, test harness V1, test harness V2. So the class files each go in their own separate files. Then I test to make sure that my test harness is working. I execute test 1 and test 2, and that does. Now that got me to those four jar files that I started out with when I was showing you. Now I'm going to combine the jar files for the version 2. So the test harness version 2 and test harness version 1. The way that I do that is I have a folder called combine, and I extract all the information in the V2 jar and the test harness V2 jar, and I combine it all back together into a temporary file called pre-test harness V2X. And the final step is to run the jar jar tool. So under the tools folder, I have the jar jar application. This executes it. I say process inrules.txt, which tells it how to manipulate the jar file. I give it my pre file, the input file, and the output file. There's my test harness V2X jar. Last step is to copy the file, which I didn't want to do indiscriminately, so I've got this commented out. Next thing I want to show you is what the input here, the input rules for jar jar links is. That is this last file. It's very simple. I said, here's the rule. I want you to look for anything that's in the org.bogus, and I want you to prefix it with org.x. That's it. So jar jar links reads this text file, executes all the rules that you can specify there, and there's different types of rules you can create, but I only need a simple one here. And it takes the input jar, writes the output jar with modifications. So finally, we can look one more time, and I can say jar tf, and we'll look at the pre. So that's before. And that's after. So before, everything was under org bogus. Now it's under org x, org bogus. And that's the way it works. Some final notes for you. This will not work. The example of using jar jar links will not work if classes are being manually loaded via a class loader. So if that is the case, there's a static string being used, and jar jar links does not identify or do anything with that. You might be able to use a class file editor. I've seen some out there. I didn't need to do that, so I haven't tried it. I imagine it would work, but that's up to you to experiment with that. The URL for the Jar Jar Links project is on the Google Code site. And if you have any questions about this, feel free to post questions to the Informatica community. But remember, I didn't write this, so I don't support it. If you are having problems, please post to the site. I may be able to respond. Others might respond. But as a community, if everyone contributes, then we all benefit from that. And last but not least, please let me know if you found this recording useful. The 10-minute expert series takes some time, and I appreciate any feedback. So thanks for your time. I hope this was helpful, and until next time.